Secretary of the Department of Defense, Nick Warner, and very, very importantly, the men and women of the Australian Defense Force. And I want to welcome all of you here today, and can I take this opportunity, because it is a gathering of the men and women of the ADF, can I take this opportunity of expressing on my behalf and on behalf of all of the people of Australia the immense admiration we have for the wonderful things you do, for your fighting quality, and for the way in which you not only fight well, but you work well with the local communities and nations of where you are dispatched. The esteem in which Australians hold the men and women of the ADF now is as high as I have known in my lifetime. And it's due to great leadership, it's due to terrific professionalism, and it is due to the fact that you understand that war fighting in the modern era is about winning wars, defending yourself, taking lives where it is necessary, regrettably, but it's also about the effective interaction with local populations. And you make us proud for what you do. That's the first thing I wanted to say. The second thing I wanted to say, I think very important, is to welcome my good friend George Bush, the President of the United States. It's not often, yes, sitting around. Mr. President, you do us great honour in spending 4 days in the beautiful city of Sydney. Which we, of course, regard as the most beautiful city in the world. And it's been on great display. If you come here as the leader of the nation that is closer to Australia than any nation in the world, peace and defence firms, the First World War at the Battle of Hamel, which was the first time that Australians and Americans fought together, and under the command of that great Australian general, Sir John Monash. And from then on, we fought in We are fighting together in Iraq and Afghanistan and other parts of the world to defend the things we hold dear. We come here as the leader of a nation to which we owe so much in terms of our defence during World War II. You come as a good friend of Australia, you come as a good friend of mine, and you come as somebody who has stood up for the things that you believe in and has demonstrated a great example of strong leadership in so doing. But you are here as a friend, you're here as a good mate of Australians, and you're amongst people who have great admiration for the common values that our two nations hold so dear. We're delighted that you're accompanied by your Secretary of State, who is held in very warm regard in this country for the wonderful work he does. And can I say that the relationship between our two countries has never been stronger. It's a relationship that is deeply rooted in history and common values, and something that is very important to all Australians. And I would like to ask you to address the assembly company, George, and to say a few words on behalf of yourself and your great nation, our very important ally. Thank you.
Improve the English.
Mr. Prime Minister, thank you for your hospitality. Jeanette, thank you for joining us. So the Prime Minister said you want to eat lunch with some of our finest citizens. I said, sure. He said, fine, I'm going to introduce you to the Australian Defence Force folks. And I appreciate you having me. It's nice barbecue you do, of course. Looking forward to a little cowboy music. But most of all, I've been looking forward to saying thanks for those who wear the uniform. These are tough times. There are times I know that your family's wondering whether or not it's worth it for you to be in the military. For those of you who've been to Iraq or Afghanistan, I saw this wounded man over here. You know, people wonder, is it worth it? Is it worth the sacrifice? And I told some folks today at the press conference, if it wasn't worth it for our own peace and security, I wouldn't put our own troops in. I believe the work that you're doing alongside our forces is necessary for peace. I believe we're writing one of the great chapters in the history of liberty and peace. And the Prime Minister gave me a chance to thank you, so I want to thank you. That's fabulous. I talk to our folks all the time about what it's like to be side by side with the officers again. And they say it's a great honor and a privilege. And so, thanks for being in the military. Thanks for representing your country. Thanks for making the sacrifice necessary for peace. The work we're doing is necessary work. And we're going to win. And you'll see. And when people look back at this chapter and picture it really, thank God for the folks like you all. Mr. Prime Minister, my name is the leader. May God bless you all. May God bless our country. Thanks for having me.